Welcome to Midnight at the Oasis, Sam Space 81. Sam Space 81, we're hopping here in Yuma, Arizona. That's cute. Wait on cars. Looking good, gentlemen. Yeah.
thing sits right.
Thank you.
it's got a coming season.
Interesting. That's bitching.
Boy, they did a hell of a number on this truck, didn't they? Damn.
Man, he changed it up, huh?
Thank you. suppose.
Well, thank you. I learned something. I won't question them now. I'll know right away. We were talking about differences between a 53 and a 54. This is a 54. Splash apron, reminiscent of a 56. That's what he was telling me. It's got 409 in it. Big power. Hit a stick. What a neat hot rod.
I had a brand new bubble top wheel in 62. Cost my dad $2,200. It was a strip model. I ordered it with a heavy duty, they call it heavy duty. It wasn't high performance. The federal mandate that the automakers don't call them high performance because people would street race. So it's called heavy duty. I had a 409. That's what they call it, the square 409, because cubic inch and horsepower was the same.
Yes.
Then I had a heavy-duty nodular transmission that they had for the Daytona, for the racers. Had nodular gears in it, not the regular T10. The rear end was a P-case. It's like, that's got nodular gears in there for Daytona. It's wiped out. Then I just recovered the seat to the original.
So you had that 409 in your garage waiting to put it in something. You said...
Yeah. 20 years ago, I had the motor sitting in the garage because it was my bucket list.
Yes. Yeah. So you found this car specifically to put it in.
Yes. And it had to be a stick car.
Hydraulic? No? Boy, you got it tuned just right. It's quiet. Nobody knows how to tune those. He's got his valves set just right. Solid lift. I've never heard a solid lifter that lift that quiet. Now, do you set it cold?
Yeah. I go by the fire order.
You do have it just tuned, just where you can drive it.
Oh, yeah.
Just right. Not too much cam.
Well, it's got a good-sized cam, 500
liters. Oh, does it? Thank you.
boat. They're hard to find.
And I got 460 in it. Yep. Out of a Lincoln. Hot rod trick.
Since I was
16
and a half,
17.
Wow.
Awesome.
Wow.
I don't live here now, but used to race just like that, American feet. From First Avenue all the way to the curb. Stop by to stop by. Man, it sat for 37 years, and about 8 years ago, I went to the bottom up. That's why there's a lot of old school.
Yeah.
Don't ask him. Always like to talk to the women. Just kidding.
All these guys,
you guys will come in here and talk all about the park, right? And your wives don't know anything about it. And they're going, okay, yeah, whatever.
No, don't ruin it for me.
And they'll miss it. They might call this a business trip. Here's how you tell. If you're walking up front, I always like to tell the women, forget the men. That's up to them. You look at the front. All you have to do is you don't have to care about any chrome. All you have to do is look at the turn signal. Teardrop, 55. It's square, it's a 56.
Let me show you something.
Yes.
Oh, wait, that's 55.
So you guys are walking in the back. I want you to do the same thing over there.
Walking on the back.
You see he's got his trunk up? See that trunk up? Here's my trunk, it's up. See the one that says white? It has a trunk up. Okay, that, you're looking in the back, right? Not doing the turn. All you have to worry about is stop light. Straight down, like this, that's a 55. They have a ball bottom like that.
I bought it. Yes.
That's cool. The Oldsmobile with all that stuff on it.
I could have never used that last time.
Yeah.
Car.
Thank you.
Are y'all going to the Greyhound Park?
Yeah.
Okay. Where is the Greyhound Park? Do you know? Is it close to here? That park, that Greyhound Park? That's like something y'all would have thrown together when you was kids, wasn't it? Like that? It's got a V8 in it. Flat end.
It was in a junkyard?
Yeah.
Tacna, California.
Tacna, Yuma, in Arizona.
Oh, okay.
Just about 45 minutes from here.
Wow. Cool save.
Yeah, I put new wheels, tires on it, the interior panels, got the engine running and driving just a few days ago.
Congratulations, man. Good looking dash.
It's for sale.
Nice. I can't believe how rich it's running. You better start it up for me. Sure. Old 6-volt charging system.
That's a key.
Might well save your juice, man.
Ah, it's all right. These old 6 volts, they
I hear you. Morning.
I love this car. That is one beautiful shoebox. Yes.
He likes it too.
Inside, all this was missing. The grills all pushed in. The hood ornament was broken in two pieces. All these panels and all that, door handles, everything was all missing. The bumpers and bumper brackets were gone. That's all that stuff I had to find.
And what was your name?
Mike.
I'm Sam Mallow.
Sam?
It's a pleasure to meet you, sir.
Okay.
Appreciate you bringing it out.
Oh, well, good. I'm glad you got to see it. Like I said, you're probably not going to see another one.
No, it's a real treat.
They're not around.
Appreciate your service, too.
I couldn't do it, even if all the parts were in front of me.
Brand new parts.
I know.
Yeah. Now, it started out to be how many hours, but then it got to be in, well, maybe years. Next year, and then it went to year after year, and finally, 13 years, I finally got the plates for it and got it on the road.
Very nice, beautiful.
We'll be right back.
Midnight at the Oasis. Put your class to bed. Thank you.
That's a beautiful car. Spice 81, we're wrapping it up here at midnight at the Oasis. I appreciate everybody tuning in. Be sure and subscribe and hit that bell if you haven't, if you like what you're seeing. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching Sam Space 81.
There we go.
Thank you.
Gotcha.
You gotta shut it up.